Quarantine hacks. Woman stockpiles $60,000 worth of goods. We've heard people doing extreme things during this quarantine season. Many have gone on a panic shopping spree while others are trying to maintain their penny-pinching ways to ensure they're utilizing resources to the max. These extreme cheapskates and couponers will either make you envy them or just get grossed out by their extremes. Our best pick is a woman who has stockpiled over $60,000 worth of household supplies, including food items that can last her for months. At the end of this video, please comment sharing the one item you've panic bought. So, let's get to it. Number 5. Stephanie cooks lasagna in a dishwasher. Not sure you want to try out this hack, but as supplies run short during these trying times, utilizing resources seems to be the only way out, and Stephanie isn't taking any chances. Stephanie is as proud of an extreme cheapskate as you're likely ever to meet. Her boyfriend Patrick, on the other hand, is embarrassed by it. And Stephanie certainly goes to extreme measures to save a buck. To cut down on energy costs, her family has one light bulb that they bring around the house with them to light up the room they're in. If they separate, say go to the bathroom, there's a candle they can use. Stephanie has small children, and any uneaten food gets put back into the containers they came out of to be recycled later. It's pretty gross when Stephanie proudly says she reuses her boiling water for cooking over and over again, and when a close-up shot of the said water appears on camera, we can see how murky it is. What's worse is that we witnessed her prepare a meal for her family with the same water. When her boyfriend asks when she intended to change the water, Stephanie gets defensive and even decides not to do it anytime soon. That's not all. As the kids finish their meals, all the extra sauce is collected in a jar for later use, as is the culture. As if that isn't gross enough, Stephanie collects lint from the washer and uses them as cotton replacements. She has several uses for it, including for her nail polish removal and makeup application. She stocks a huge bag equating to enough supply for a couple of months. We got to see her true colors when her boyfriend Patrick mentioned he wanted to have friends over for a football party. Stephanie wasn't open to the idea considering it would take her off her monthly household budget. She, however, decides to allow her boyfriend to have his moment and offers to do the shopping. While at the grocery store, she unpeeled bananas and took grapes off the vines so they'll weigh less when she goes to pay for them. Other shoppers seem shocked by her weird behavior, but Stephanie couldn't care less. She approached the butcher to get steak for her lasagna preparation, but the butcher serving her was shocked to find out she was looking for a cheap deal on expired meat. Unfortunately, this wasn't her lucky day. She was, however, able to get a deal on beef fat, which she was to have it minced and add to the little steak she had at home to fill her lasagna. Preparations for the lasagna were going smooth as she used her recycled pasta sauce. Thank goodness she didn't tell that trick to Patrick's guests. We get to cringe some more when she explains why she uses her dishwasher to make her lasagna instead of wasting space while washing her dishes. She says it gets to about 170 degrees and sealing with foil sheets helps avoid it from soaking. She puts her lasagna in together with her dishes as she waits for the guests to arrive. Everyone was speechless at their cheapskate ways. The hilarious, if not absurd part was when Patrick had to switch off the TV during every commercial break to save on electricity. His guests also had to adapt to using a candle to go to the washroom since there were no light bulbs around the house. As the worst was expected, they didn't seem very surprised to know the lasagna was prepared in a dishwasher. Patrick's guests seemed to indicate that the lasagna tasted like water or perhaps that was all the beef fat she used to make the beef go further. It certainly seemed gross as they parted to eat it. However, the negative reviews couldn't faze Stephanie. I get the utmost satisfaction being the cheapskate that I am. It's for me and my family, not anybody else, she said. I don't care what nobody says. It was the Stephanie way, and the Stephanie way is the better way. Do you think Stephanie is extreme? Under the same video, a YouTube viewer noticed how her nails were always done and asked how she could afford to do so and yet act so cheap. Number 4. Michael bruises coffee with a sock. Michael, an IT worker, is a proud cheapskate from Tennessee. He spends his time inventing new ways to cut costs. So far, his inventions have reduced his monthly spending down to under $1,000. Michael shows us a gross makeshift coffee strainer made from an old sock. He seems to have no problem with everything and prides on how convenient his device was. His parents even make a joke on how he's the cheapest person they know. He tries to use milk crates for shelves instead of getting $20 to $50 shelves. Michael refuses to throw away anything that he might be able to construct into a money-making contraption. Due to his penny-pinching ways, he generates less trash per week. Showing off his tool belt made from duct tape was hilarious. The thing didn't seem solid enough to hold some tools in the first place. His rubber band idea for holding soap was a genius idea we could all adopt, as it saves him a couple of hundreds of dollars and prevents his soap from getting mildew. It doesn't end there. We appreciate that he tries to recycle straws, but his way of cleaning them are questionable. To the part that shocked most, if not all of the audience, is the crazy idea of cutting his water bill by recycling his bathwater for dish and laundry washing. His parents also agree that it's very gross and unhygienic. Although he spends less than $15 per month on water, this guy isn't satisfied yet and wants to cut down his bills completely. That's why we can see him trying to construct an indoor pump and a rainwater collecting system. Number 3. Toilet paper apocalypse newspaper hack. If post-apocalyptic movies get one thing right, it's this. You don't see anyone using toilet paper after the end of the world. The world isn't ending yet, but some people are shopping like it is amid the ongoing coronavirus outbreak. Perhaps the wildest panic seems to surround toilet paper, which is flying off the shelves. However, Melody and Ron Rose Gravett, who live in Tallahena, Oklahoma with their two sons, reveal in a trailer for the show of Extreme Cheapskates that their favorite cost-cutting techniques include sharing the same bathwater. As much as Melody tries to make the whole experience seem wholesome by claiming they aren't dirty, their children seem less enthused about their strict budgeting, and in one clip, 15-year-old Brandon tells viewers, "Sometimes I do actually want to take my own shower, but I can't really do much about it because my parents like to save water." Indeed, one frame shows his 9-year-old brother Ronnie taking a bath in his parents' water, which appears to have turned a shade of brown. However, his mother brushes over this, telling him, "Oh my goodness, looks like you've had a good time. You smell good." That's not all that makes us question the ways of this country family. As people are rushing for toilet paper across the world, these folks prefer using free newspapers in place of shop-bought toilet paper. Melody shows the camera how she uses toilet paper and crumbles it up as she proceeds to explain that they stock up the used newspaper in a bag, then burn it. She claims it's not about being able to afford it, but the fact that they simply don't need it. She's even insulated the toilet windows with newspapers to use during emergencies. Despite having electricity, this family hardly uses it and prefers replacing lighting in the house with a lantern. This means they also don't need a heater and all sleep in one huge bed so they could cuddle and share the heat. As far as appliances are concerned, everything including laundry is done manually. Their underground refrigerator sounds like a smart idea, but it's questionable how they keep perishable foods fresh. Things get even crazier when their eldest daughter, who lives in the city, goes to visit them for 2 weeks and is forced to adapt to their cheapskate ways. Luckily, they weren't forced to share bathwater, but had to have squirrels and frog legs for dinner. This got me thinking, if things got really thick, what's the odd thing people on this list have done so far that you'd consider trying for your survival? Number 2. $1,000 wedding. Such a wedding could be ideal considering large gatherings are currently prohibited in most places. Shelly, who's a mother of two, has been penny-pinching in Mesa, Arizona for over 20 years. But Shelly's biggest money-saving challenge is going to be throwing her daughter's Ashley's wedding on a $1,000 budget. She wanted her daughter's wedding to be held in a run-down high school gym because she was getting it for free. Everyone found it ridiculous since it was not a fancy venue, but Shelly wasn't ready to back down. Despite most people spending over $3,000 on flowers, Shelly had scored a deal from a holiday decoration warehouse, and since the flowers are out of season, they were cheaper for them. Even the store manager told the cameras it was the cheapest deal they've ever made. The cake was worse. They negotiated with a local baker to lend them the display cake in return for free advertising on the wedding day, something they too had never seen or heard before. The stop at the pawn shop was shocking for us all. She bargained for a $75 wedding dress that was covered in rat pee. Watching how things got worse as the episode progressed just made us feel sorry for Ashley. The guests were served sandwiches on school trays and were even advised to BYOB. Just wondering how she would feel about extremely cheap wedding presents. Here, I picked you up this used item in a thrift shop for your wedding present. Cringe. Number 1. Woman stockpiles $60,000 worth of goods. Away from the cheapskates, we moved to an extreme couponer, Siobhan, who had over $60,000 worth of supplies. Her grandmother, Flossie, left her a treasure trove of coupons with no expiration dates, and Siobhan wants to make sure she uses them to get maximum savings. They even have a motto, 50 cents or less, but free is the best. At her house, she has a pile of supplies, including frozen meats. A majority of viewers were concerned about the expiration dates of these items and if she donated some to the needy. What was interesting was the canned food system, where she had arranged them all according to expiry dates. Everything had been arranged systematically from foodstuffs to detergents to other sorts of supplies on shelves. She tries to show the cameras her supply of over 300 toothbrushes, and we can't seem to wonder what she intends to do with all of them. The place looks like a mini mart. Just when you think that's all the couponing she could do, she reveals that she inherited a lifetime supply of coupons that have no expiration. Since her sister Mandy was running short on supplies, Siobhan agreed to help her stock up, and we see them planning their couponing spree. They were able to sort out the coupons into different categories and label them to make it easier at checkout. While at the supermarket, they could be seen shopping in bulk, doing some serious math calculations as they added things to their carts. 21 transactions later, they only spent $21.23 of their own money instead of a whopping $1,461 total of their purchase. This equated to over 98% in savings, and everyone at the store was just as shocked as the people in the comments who wished to have learned this trick before getting into a quarantine situation. What would you do with $60,000 worth of supplies?